One in eight people are chronically hungry, one in seven people are without electricity, and one in three are without sanitation. So at the most basic level, our lab aims to provide these fundamental human rights to sanitation, energy, and food security. Our lab is attempting to solve these problems using ecological wastewater treatment. Ecological wastewater treatment has many forms. One of them is this laboratory that I'm sitting in right now at Penn State. This is called an eco-machine. And an eco-machine takes wastewater in, and it passes through a series of tanks with different plants and microorganisms that purify the water without the use of chemicals and with very low amounts of energy. While there are many different organisms in the system that help treat the water, the superstar is duckweed. Duckweed is the smallest flowering plant in the world, and it sequesters nutrients out of the water and converts them into protein. We can take duckweed out of the water and use it for a variety of beneficial purposes, such as sustainable fertilizers to enrich agricultural fields. We can feed it to farm, dairy animals, and even fish in aquaponic systems. Penn State is a unique place. We have world-class research facilities. We have an enormous team of very skilled faculty. We have really hardworking students. And yet we're nestled in the hills of central Pennsylvania, where I can walk out my office and within 10 minutes be hiking in the forest. And that's a really unique set of qualities that drew me to Penn State. I always enjoy speaking at the Millennium Cafe because of all the different scientists and engineers who are present. So this time when I spoke at the Millennium Cafe, I specifically emphasized our need to provide sanitation, food, and energy to Africa. And after the presentation was over, I was so happy that two different people approached me about potentially applying duckweed technologies in their home countries in Africa. And if this is possible, this would be a great opportunity for our research to get off the ground and be applied in the developing world. I feel the most rewarding part of my research is that it's something that could actually make a difference, but also I believe in it. I feel passionate about our need to provide these solutions to the world.